We are at the moment in the middle of phase 4 of the Marvel Cinematic Universe. We've already seen WandaVision and we're just getting into the Falcon and the Winter Soldier now. And one of the big things we're going to be seeing in phase 4 is comics accurate costumes. We're getting the introduction of brand new characters to the MCU as well as new characters we've been following for the past years, but they're going to be having new comics accurate suits. And we've seen that already a little bit with WandaVision, with White Vision, with Wanda getting her Scarlet Witch look at the end of the series. Agatha Harkness had a great comics accurate look, and in the Falcon and the Winter Soldier, you already see Baron Zemo. Looks amazing. And so expect more comics accurate suits like that going forward in the MCU. And we actually have our first look at a bunch of them now. So this is a huge leak, huge spoilers and stuff, although most of these suits are going to get revealed before the actual project. So now that you've been warned, basically, I don't know where this originated from, but somebody posted this image online, and it is a bunch of concept art officially from Marvel Studios that they have sent out to different toy companies because they have to start working on making action figures and stuff like months ahead, sometimes even like a year or two ahead of time to get it out and produced and all that stuff. So there's concept art out there of all these suits, and we're going to take a look at them now. So if you don't want to see them, then turn back now, but it's too late because look at this. Now, it is just a giant grid, so I'm going to zoom in on them, but they're going to be super blurry images. But still, you get the gist of the costumes. Okay, so let's see. There we go. All right, so first of all, you can see we have Doctor Strange right here, and this was just reported on like a week or two ago. I did a video on it about how there's rumors of Doctor Strange getting a more comics accurate suit for Doctor Strange in the Multiverse of Madness. And this suit looks very similar to what he's been wearing the whole time in the MCU, but this time you see that there's like some sort of faint white pattern on his chest, and that is the comics accurate part because that's part of his costume in the comics. One thing I am disappointed about though is the lack of yellow gloves like the ones he had in Thor Ragnarok. I'd love to see him wearing those gloves again. And then also it does kind of look like he's wearing the Eye of Agamotto again, but then again it's blurry, it's kind of hard to tell. But also from the same movie we have Wong, and Wong also gets an update. Another comics accurate costume. I mean, look at that. This is like exactly how Wong looks in the comics, with like the red and the blue with like hints of gold in there. So he looks awesome there. Also from Doctor Strange 2, we have our first look at America Chavez. We know that Xochitl Gomez is going to be playing the character. Eventually she's going to go on to join the Young Avengers and everything. And this is what her suit's going to look like. And again, also very comics accurate. I mean, her costume's pretty simple. It's literally just like a jean jacket with like an American flag on it. But I mean, looks amazing. Then, really this whole first row is for Doctor Strange and the Multiverse of Madness. But we have our first look at Baron Mordo, who looks just like he does in the comics. I mean, it looks like he's got the full green suit with like a long cape and everything. He did not have the cape in the first Doctor Strange movie. He's got the gold accents there. So that just looks absolutely amazing. It makes me think that maybe he will be a villain in this movie. I don't know if he'll be the main villain, but he's definitely not going to be friends with Doctor Strange in this movie. Then we have another quick shot of Wong in there, but next to Scarlet Witch. And you can't really tell any differences between this look and her look from WandaVision, but she still looks great. Then we have probably one of the biggest reveals on here, our first look at Clea. This is a character that has not even been confirmed for this movie, so we have no idea who's playing this character, but I mean, they're filming the movie right now, so most likely the character has been cast. And in the comics, Clea is, I don't know if she's either like the, I think she's like the niece of Dormammu, or she has some sort of connection to Dormammu, and she's basically female Doctor Strange. So she's going to be introduced in this movie, and I think she looks great. Again, comics accurate, like with the purple suit, which I think is just going to be really cool to see. Now moving on to the next row, we're looking at Hawkeye. Clint Barton Hawkeye has a new suit here. Seems pretty basic, but it's purple, so I like that. You know, pays homage to his classic purple design. And then we have some various looks for Kate Bishop here, which is pretty interesting. We've seen this in set photos though, so not that big of a deal. A big reveal here is this character. You can tell that this is Ronin. This is the same Ronin suit from Avengers Endgame, but that is not Clint Barton. This looks like a female character under the hood. And we know that the character of Maya Lopez is going to be introduced in this series, and it was actually just confirmed that she's getting her own spin-off show on Disney Plus. And in the comics, Maya Lopez also takes on the mantle of Ronin after Clint Barton. So I feel like this is our first look at her as Ronin, and again, it's the same suit, but also it's confirmation that that's what they're doing here. So that I'm really excited for that. Also, from Hawkeye, we have our first look at Yelena Belova, because it has been confirmed that she will also be appearing in this series as well. Obviously, she'll be introduced in the Black Widow movie. There's also rumors of her appearing in the Falcon and the Winter Soldier, but this is our first look at her in Hawkeye. And again, not a big change, but this is taking place way, like, almost 10 years after Civil War. So, like, at this point, like, it makes sense that she has a different look than, time to move on to the bottom row here, where we have our first look at the Ms. Marvel suit, and straight out of the comics, this just looks exactly like she does in the comics. And then some other looks here are just for like her Halloween costume and stuff. Looks like she's wearing a Black Widow shirt, because we know she's a superhero fan. And then this is also our first look at Red Dagger, who I don't know too much about, but seems like he's going to be a pretty cool character. And again, that's the big thing I'm talking about here, is just look at the comics accuracy of all these characters' costumes. They look exactly like they do in the comics, and I just love that so much. So, guys, this is awesome. I can't wait to see what these suits actually look like in live action, in action. One suit that I'm surprised was not revealed here was the Falcon Captain America suit, which we do know we're going to be seeing in the Falcon the Winter Soldier, and we didn't see anything from Loki, but I don't know. This is just awesome. I'm just excited for all of these, for all these new characters, all these returning characters with comics accurate suits. Like, you got Doctor Strange with the updated suit. Wong looks amazing. Clea being introduced here. America Chavez. Maya Lopez is Ronin. Yelena Belova returning. You know, Red Dagger as well. Ms. Marvel. I'm just excited for all this stuff, man. Like the MCU is. It's not going down anytime soon. I mean, people were like, oh, we're done after Endgame. But no way, Jose. We're just getting started. You know, the Infinity Saga, that was just a warm-up. Now we're really getting going with the MCU. And that is there's just so much proof here with this one grid of costumes, because it just looks so good. And I might make a few other videos about this throughout the week of these first looks, just of like the bigger things. So stay tuned for those as well. But let me know your thoughts on this in the comments below. What do you think about our first looks at all these different costumes from the upcoming Phase 4 projects of the MCU? So, thanks so much for watching. Please drop a like if you enjoyed this video, and hit the subscribe button so I can keep up to date on everything goes on in the Marvel.